Can you talk a little bit about what makes the What's on Stage Awards such a very special night for performers and audiences?
Well, obviously, because it's voted by the audience, it means the most. And so I'm just happy to be here. It's my night off, but it's really nice to be out with my husband tonight because I feel like I haven't actually been able to look him in the eye for a few weeks because I've been so busy. So, yeah. But the What's on Stage, I always read the What's on Stage website for news about theatre and stuff, so I'm quite sort of a fan anyway. But it's great just because it's voted for by the audience. So,
and in terms of live theatre, can you talk about for you what the unique magic of that is, both for performers and an audience?
Yeah, well, I don't think there's ever any getting away from the fact that the live experience is the best. I do just love doing theatre more than anything else. I really like doing Home, I'm Darling, because it's a show that really feels like it lands with audiences, and I can feel that, you know, and then I can go home feeling like my day's work's done. Whereas with TV, you know, it's great, but you make it and then it's sort of months before it comes out and then you don't really know what the audience thought. You just read sort of a couple of reviews and, you know, that's kind of not quite the same experience. But, you know, I'll never say no to TV at the same time, but I will always prioritise theatre, I think.
In terms of Home, I'm Darling, for people who haven't been lucky enough to see that yet, can you talk a little bit about what it is about that story that landed with you as a storyteller?
Well, I think it's a very original play. I think it's a very original idea of a woman who decides to live in the 1950s. But I also think it's just quite relevant because, in a way, it's about the small things in people's lives, like getting a promotion and whether you think your husband's being faithful and so on. There's no big kind of huge events that, but I feel like it probably resonates with people's lives quite a lot because a lot of people will have been through the things that Judy goes through in the play. And certainly that's how it feels when we're doing it. It feels like it's resonating, you know, with people.
I'm curious, when you look back to that point in our history, does it change your own perspective on things that we're going through right now in 2019?
In the 1950s? Well, I think a lot of people have said, you know, it's got Brexit connotations to this play. And I think it's interesting that, because although it was written and conceived of before any of all that happened, I do think we're all harking after a time that probably never existed. And nostalgia is sort of a disease, and I think we're all kind of in the grips of it, definitely.
Obviously, we're celebrating theatre from across the country, but I'm curious what is uniquely special about the West End, what makes it, for many people, the theatre capital of the world still?
Well, I think the West End's so exciting because, I mean, I'm a huge musical theatre fan, as somebody who doesn't do and can't do musical theatre. But also, you can have a play like Home, I'm Darling, which is a new, you know, straight play. I mean, it's sort of a comedy, but it's a play, you know. It's thriving in the West End alongside something like All About Eve and, you know, with things like Book of Mormon round the corner. And I think it's just so rich that it's important to keep the kind of straight plays jostling for business alongside the big musicals and everyone sort of feeding off each other. And I think that's what makes it so special, yeah.